Welcome to the Sunshine Training Center. For tips, how-tos, and videos on burn rehabilitation, subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit our blog at www.sunshinetraining.org. In this series on innovations in rehabilitation, we'll demonstrate how to make a grip aid that can be used by people who lost function in both hands. This innovation was prepared by Ching-Yuan Lin, Senior Occupational Therapist at the Taipei Rehabilitation Center of Sunshine Foundation. It was originally published as an article in Burns Open.
Hello, in this video, I will show you how to make a grip aid for patients with bilateral loss of grasp function. Universal cuff is often used to provide users with limited grip strength and dexterity more control when manipulating utensils or writing tools. However, for patients with bilateral loss of grasp function due to nerve injury or amputation, putting on the universal cuff independently can be problematic. We propose a modified design that solves this problem. To make the grip aid, you will need a heating pan and heating gun, splinting scissors and regular scissors, a hole punch, as well as a sewing machine or thread and needle. We recommend using thermoplastic splinting material with good conformability and good memory, like Aqua Plus or Aqua Cast, that is convenient for shaping and modification. You will also need adhesive Velcro hook and non-adhesive Velcro loop. First, cut a rectangular piece of splinting material. Its length should be about twice the width of the patient's palm, while its width should be about 3/4 of the distance between the patient's wrist and MP joints. Cut an opening in the center of the splint, at about 1/3 below the upper edge. After fitting the opening so that it corresponds to the position of the thumb, shape the splint around the patient's hand. At the edge of the splint on the side of the little finger, use a hole punch to make holes in a continuous line to create one straight, long opening. The length of the opening should be bigger than the width of the Velcro hook and loop. Cut a long piece of non-adhesive Velcro loop and sew one end back, filled side facing outward to form a pull ring end. Stick the adhesive Velcro hook on the outer and inner sides of the splint. Then, pass the non-adhesive Velcro loop through the long opening and fasten the end of the loop to the inner adhesive Velcro hook. Wrap the rest of the loop over the splint and fasten it to the outer adhesive Velcro hook. Cut a small 2 cm by 4 cm piece of the splinting material. Heat it and then shape it into a clip. An object like a pen can be used to shape the opening of the eye to an adequate size. Cut a small piece of splinting material, about 0.5 cm by 4 cm. Shape it as a circle that will be the joint between the clip and the body of the splint to strengthen the joint contact area. After conforming the angle of the clip eye, fix the small circle joint to the body of the splint, and fix the clip eye to the small circle joint. Place a tool, like a pen, inside the clip eye and put the splint on the patient's hand. The modified design helps improve autonomy and convenience of wearing assistive devices for patients without grip function in both hands. First, the pruring end of the non-adhesive Velcro loop makes it easy for patients who lost grip function of both hands to use their mouth to pull off the loop and secure the splint in place. Second, the bill-like design will prevent the splint from rotating and is more convenient. Third, by cutting the splint from the center into a Y shape, so that the area where the tool is fixed and the fastening strap do not overlap, The patient won't be restricted by the tool when using his mouth to fasten or opening the non-adhesive Velcro loop. Finally, the modified clip design makes it convenient for use of multiple tools, a pen, a toothbrush, etc., without having to make another separate grip aid. We do not recommend using this device when wounds or blisters are present over the volar and dorsal side of hand, especially the area directly in contact with the splint. Also, the clip design can only support lightweight tools. For heavier tools requiring sturdier attachment, it is recommended to wrap the object in splinting material and fix it directly to the body of the splint.
Thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe to our channel for more burn rehabilitation related tips and videos, and visit our website for news about our latest training programs.